Hello, I'm Satish Gupta, working as a Java trainer in Arisha Technologies. Welcome to Java 8 video series. In this video, we'll talk about the characteristics of a stream. So when you see the characteristics of a stream, the first one is, a stream is not a data structure. The first characteristic is, a stream is not a data structure. Now, actually, which one is a data structure here? Collection. So, collection is a data structure. Because in collection, the data is stored by following certain rules and regulations. So, here collection is having data, right? Collection is having data, and this data is stored in the form of objects. But stream is not a data structure where the stream doesn't have any data. There is no data in what here? Stream. Okay? There is no data in a stream, but stream read the data from a source through one pipeline and perform certain operations. And stream, okay, stream is not a data structure, so it doesn't contain any data. So it just read the data and perform certain operations. Okay? And not only that, a stream is immutable, means the stream doesn't do any changes in underlying data structure. It means, for example, now if I'm using iterator, you can do changes in what? Collection, because iterator support certain methods like removing. Okay, remove is a method of iterator, then it will remove. Suppose if we take list iterator, it will try to perform so many operations on collection. It is not only read it, but it also performs certain operations like adding, removing and what? Updating. But when it comes to a stream, stream is completely immutable. Means using stream, you can just read the data, but you cannot modify the data exist in what? Collection. Stream is not a data structure. It doesn't contain any data, but a stream read data from a source, that source can be a collection. From that it perform, read the data and perform certain operations. And stream is, okay, stream doesn't do any changes. Stream doesn't do any changes in what? Collection. Its operation is just reading the data but not changing the data. Okay. So this is first characteristics, that is, it is not a data structure. Okay, so second characteristics of a stream is, so streams are designed for lambdas. Okay, it means every function provided by stream, a stream provides some set of functions, right? Set of methods or set of functions, and these methods uses lambda as an expression. Okay, all the methods of stream uses lambda as an expression. Means streams uses functional programming. Okay, streams support functional programming. For example, a stream provide one method called filter. Assume that. A stream provide a method called filter. Now assume that this is a collection. This collection is having number of objects, like these are integer objects. Assume that I want to filter even numbers. Then this filter required an expression. This filter required one function. And that function, this filter required one expression, or that filter required one function, where it read the element and apply this function. And this function which finds whether that number is even or what? Odd. It means the methods which provided by a stream, by nature, it is functional. Functional means it takes a lambda as what? expression. Now this is one more characteristics of a stream, that is designed for what? Lambdas. Okay. The third characteristics of a stream is, do not support index. It means generally stream, okay, stream is used reading data in sequential. Okay, stream is used to read the data from a collection in sequential. So the third characteristic is, so stream do not support or does not support indexed access or index accessing, right? Index accessing. Okay, stream generally, for example, if you work with the files, right? If you work with the files where you find IO streams. Okay, now with the help of this IO streams, for example, there is an input stream. Using this input stream, I can read the data from the file either in sequential or I can read what here? Random. If I want to read random, I need to define the place from where I want to read it. But when it comes to a stream, okay, stream does not support index accessing. It means always a stream read the data in sequential order. Always a stream read the data in sequential order, but I cannot read the data randomly. Because in order to read the data randomly, I should use what? Index accessing. Okay, stream doesn't support what? Index accessing. Always a stream is what here? Sequential. If I want to read the second element, first I need to read first element and then what? Second element. If I want to read the third element, first I need to read first element, second element and then third element. But I cannot read it randomly, right? So by default, a stream does not support what? Index accessing, right? Now this is one more characteristics of a stream. Okay, I hope you understood these three characteristics. So where I said first one is, streams are not data structures. Stream is not a data structure. Okay, stream is not a data structure. Means it doesn't contain the data, but it just read the data and perform certain operations. So it is not a data structure. This is the first characteristics of a stream. Okay, second one, what I said is, streams are designed for lambdas. Okay, streams are designed for lambdas means stream methods support functional programming. And third one, a stream do not support index accessing. It will not support index accessing. I hope you understood these three characteristics. We'll see more characteristics in next video. Okay, so thanks for watching this. For more videos, subscribe Naresh IT channel.